Now I'm walking on a dream, but you know that I'm alone. Would you join my own journey? 'Cause these stars aren't bright as you. Now I'm walking on a dream, and you're now I'm walking on a dream, and the sky is in my mind. Will you join my own journey? 'Cause the light belongs to us. I love you.
Unpleasant to watch, I'll give you that.
Yeah, it's just what happens in the, you know, slaughterhouses. It's like basically where meat comes from.
Is this like industry meat? Like
like any meat really, but yeah, just because it's the industry is made to be so efficient that they just really don't care, like, about, yeah, it just really just shows.
Yeah.
What the animals go through to get on the plate, really.
It's pretty brutal, yeah.
You know, have you ever heard of halal?
Halal?
Yeah. What do you think about that?
Well, I feel like the animal still dies.
Yeah.
And for me, in order to live, to survive, to thrive and be healthy, I don't need something to die.
Fair enough. So are you vegetarian or vegan?
I'm vegan. Yeah. And I have been for almost 3 years now. Amazing.
I learned in Islam, the halal, the whole thing about it is that you have to do it, you have to make the animal feel as like comfortable as you can. So there's this day called Eid, and it's a celebration day.
Yeah.
And the aim of it is just like to slaughter the animal. Obviously there's rules like how you do it to make it like, instead of being like shooting everyone and all them in the head, they actually, you put a blanket on the pen so they can't see what's happening. You carry them out one like at a time.
Yeah.
And then you have to like just lay it down and relax it. And then you do it, and then it's the way they cut it, it's like makes it give us like the quickest death. And it's like, obviously, like if you're vegan, it's still like bad, like you, in your eyes, you know, which is understandable.
Well,
but it's like in our culture, it's like just the way of life, how it works. And the meat, you obviously keep some for yourself, the rest you gotta, like it's best to donate it. So you actually donate it to poor people.
Mm.
So that's like the culture of Islam, like that's one part of it,
the
part.
So, Where are you from? What's your culture? Yeah.
Māori and Australian.
Okay, so you're saying that eating meat is part of your culture. That's why you would give it up. Well, culture, tradition, they're all stories.
Yeah.
So you're basically like killing or participating in the killing of a venison animal just because of stories.
Yeah.
You know what? You know. Get my point?
I can understand where you're coming from, yeah.
And this is definitely the wrong way to do it anyway.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like we're killing an animal like the Native Americans killed one animal to feed. And don't get me wrong, I would never do that anyway.
Yeah.
But I'm saying things are getting a bit out of hand and, you know.
I was trying to understand, there's a show on SBS, something about your meat, is an Australian dude, he does it.
Yeah, this is actually local footage, like most of this.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
It's Australian footage. Not only you're killing the animals in the most cruel way, but you're also participating in deforestation because obviously we're giving the land to get these animals, to breed these animals, and we're feeding all the grain to the animals instead of feeding the grain to the people that actually want to eat food and are hungry. So there's like four or five sides to veganism. I would definitely not stop for culture and tradition. Like I would always
part
and just
it's
wrong and right.
Yeah.
It's just that. And that's wrong.
Yo, I'm gonna have to go now, but
no, that's fine.
I'll even find
one
thing like Islam, like the religion is all about like almost Aboriginal American Indian. It's that thing is you know, the circle of life, like so like when you kill an animal, like you can't just kill it and let it go to waste. Like it's like all those cultures, you have to make sure you never take too much, and you only take what you need, you know. And if
but
you're,
it doesn't work that way these days.
And that's why the West, it's mainly the West.
The only, if we want to survive after in like 50 years, the whole world will have to turn vegan.
Fair enough.
Because veganism, to live the way we're living now and to kill the way we're killing now, we would have to have a meat planet.
Testosterone from animals cycling out before they're slaughtered. That's actually carcinogenic to the human body. So we're eating poison and they're just, you know, just from being so scared, that's what they're doing. Let alone all the additives. All the red food dyes they add to make your meat seem nice and fresh because it's actually green before you get it. It's like olive green because it's mold. So they can really make it look nice
this
and fresh.
This is a massive bio.
Yeah.
Inshallah, man. You know, one day the world sees how fucked up it is.
Yeah.
I wish you all the best.
It's really hidden from the public for a reason.
Yeah.
Because people wouldn't be doing that. You'd be like, that's disgusting. I'm not going to eat that if you knew exactly what happened to it. You know, it doesn't matter if it's grain free. It's You know, if it's been in a paddock or a, you know, just a whole warehouse his whole life, at the end of the day, it goes to the slaughterhouse and we eat it. And then we suffer and get sick, cancers and tumors from eating it.
Yeah, it's really good. I have to go. But no worries, man. Bro. I really appreciate what you're saying.
Yeah,
it's
real fun. Cheers, man.
Spread the message.
Exactly. That's the real problem, is we believe we're more superior.
Yeah, we think we're more intelligent, more like you guys are doing an awesome job. Like, so good. Nice to meet you.
Look, thank you so much for stopping by.
Yeah, no worries. No, like I honestly admire that. Holding those laptops, first of all, just sitting there.
Now I'm walking on a dream, but you know that I'm alone. Would you join my own journey? 'Cause these stars aren't bright as you. Now I'm walking on a dream, and you're always in my head. Would you join my own journey?
just shoot it?
But it's just a common practice everywhere, really, around the world.
Thank you. stars are as bright as you. Now I'm walking on a dream.
We're here at the event, at the box event, and it's been like a couple of hours and everyone's still doing incredible and amazing and spreading the word and trying to show the truth of what really goes on in the industries, meat, dairy, you know, fishing, egg industries and so on. And it has just been incredibly moving, and it's amazing just to see like the reactions of the people and how they react when they see what really goes on. And some people are open to the idea and some people are just really quiet, like, you know, not ready for it yet, obviously. But it is quite amazing, and I'm just grateful that there are organizations like this organization is Anonymous for the Voiceless. They do things like that, because otherwise you might never really know what veganism is. You might never really see what goes on behind the doors.